Hi friends, I hope you guys are able to listen to me now. Now, the first thing is, if someone can say hi or hello to me, it will be easy to for me to understand that you guys are there online. Now, the first thing is that a lot of people ask, you know, for freshers, what, you know, basic things which need to be take care of while preparing the resume or sharing the profile. And other thing is, if those who are experienced, then what are the things which need to be taken care of it? Now, for freshers, there's nothing much. You need to start with your basic details. First would be your name, your contact details, then your address, and then about your career objective. What exactly do you want to be in your career? Post that comes to your that's what you say. If you have any work experience or any skills, what, you know, if you have specialized in any particular skills or something, like if I talk about the technology wise or technical wise, like you are Java or .NET, or you are have some certification or something, mention that those skills. Post that, you need to, if you, in case you have any kind of experience, be it a year or two, just you know, you need to mention those experience. Your current experience should be the first one, and post that, it will be like, you know, gradually it will be happening. And once you're done with the education, your experience part, post that, it will be your education qualification. Now, main important thing is, whenever you are mentioning about, be it experience or freshers, is for both. Whenever you are mentioning about your education thing in your resume, see to it that you know, you are mentioning the board or university by which you have done, college name, either as SSC or SCBSE or ICSE board or any other board from which you have done, the name of the university is Mumbai, Pune or Delhi University, and the course which you have done it, and the year of passing. The reason behind it, you know, because a lot of organizations look for each and every details, and obviously the percentage which you have scored during those you know, courses or classes or anything, a subject or any particular thing. And post that comes to your hobbies and interest. And the last would be like, you know, simple things. Now, other thing is, when you are a fresher, say to it that, you know, your resume should not extend for a 1.5 page. The reason we and if you, in case you are experienced, obviously your resume would be, you know, around, it can be like 2 or 3 pages, but keep it as simple as possible. Keep it neat and clean. Don't make it like, you know, don't put each and everything in your resume. Now, for freshers, it's very important to know whatever you know, achievements you have done in a college or in your other extracurricular activities, and all mentioning those things. If you have done any kind of a promotional jobs or event jobs as a part-timer, or, you know, just for 2-3 years, mention those things as well, because those are an added advantage. Then for okay, now these are the basic things, and when you are experienced, otherwise, the format remains the same for these things. But for experienced, mention it whenever, we come across a lot of profiles where they just mention the name of the organization and the designation, but they don't mention their job responsibilities, what exactly they are doing. Even if you have worked as a normal accountant, as an accountant, what are things you were doing? Were you working on tally? What kind of entries you were doing? And all those things, at least, you know, a bit of briefing has to be there. And also mentioning the skills is very important for you guys, because we search profiles as per the keywords which we get from the client. And if you have any questions based on, like, you know, a particular thing, like, you know, how, what all things to be added and all, you can come up with those, your questions, and I'll be happy to give you the answers of all your queries and all. So these are the basic things which I have informed you. And in your resume, and other thing is, whenever you are forwarding your profile, see to it that you know whether your profile is matching to the requirement or not. Like we do, you post profiles on you know where you look for a job via Naukri or anyone or any other portal like Monster or anything. Analyze it, you know, whether are you, you know, a proper fit to the requirement or no. What exactly they are looking, are you on the similar line of work or no? Like say, for example, if you guys are from operations and the requirement is for sales, obviously it's a mismatch. So don't go for such requirements, which is a mismatch. Look out for the keywords because any recruiter will not put a keywords, what exactly they're looking out for. Say, for example, if I talk about the sales or marketing, it will be either sales or marketing. It will not be a mixed profile. So for marketing, again, it's a very vast. So whether you know, we put the keywords, like you know, the person has to be into digital marketing, or the person has to be a branding, or the person has to be from a corporate communication team and all. So look at those keywords. You know, what keywords are matching to your profile. And other thing is whenever you are putting your keywords, it will be we have done. Like if I talk about the finance thing, in finance also there are a lot of things. For a few of the organization will look for taxation. Few of the organization will look for financial analysis and planning. Some of them will look for credit analysis. Some of them will be like accounts receivable and payable. So those keywords are very important. I mean, though, whenever you are putting a profile, when you're uploading your profile on any of the social media sites like or any of the portal, put those keywords as a highlight. Because those keywords, because whenever we are also searching those profiles, we put the keywords. Like say, for example, if I am putting, I have to search a profile for any of the particular requirement if I had to talk about, like take it like finance and accounts. Like I'm looking someone who have worked on proper financial reporting or say typically for accounts payable or accounts receivable. So we will put those keywords in the search criteria. So always put the keywords whenever you are uploading a profile or anywhere. Those are the main important things, even for freshers or experienced. Experienced people are aware what exactly they want have, you know, they have done in the career and what they want to do and what exactly they would be looking out for. For freshers, they need to actually look out for, you know, what exactly they, where they want to pursue their career. Now, one more very important thing for freshers. Now, those who have been, you know, either a final year of their any of the college or any of the institute, any of the things, see to it that, you know, if in case you are getting a job through a campus, take it. Whether you like it or you don't like it, take that job. Because most of the organizations would prefer a campus hiring. They take the, you know, a bunch of freshers from campus itself. They will never ever go to a consultant, and other thing is whenever the organization is hiring you via campus, they'll always pay you a higher salary compared to those who are going for a walk-in interviews in the organization. So whenever any organization is giving you a job, offering you a job as a fresher through a campus interview, take it. In the meantime, you might look out for a job which suits you or which you feel the company is much better. You don't want to this ABC company, you want that XYZ company. At least take up an offer from ABC organization because you never know whether you will be getting a job from that XYZ company or no. And then you will be wasting your time in between that. Because as I told you earlier also, because maximum organizations, if you see, they prefer hiring, going for a campus interviews and all because they search for the best candidate. And other thing is for both freshers and experienced, you need to keep on updating yourself on whichever new technology is coming. We being an experienced people at times we feel the new technology has upgraded, but if we are not updating ourselves with the time, it will be like, we won't be able to sustain in the organization because nowadays every second or third day that new technologies are coming. the new updates are coming. Even if you open and even you talk about the mobile application, you will see in every second or third day that some other new update will be happening. The same way, you also need to keep on updating yourself via social media, or via, you can read your books as per your interest. Like if you are from a marketing or finance or any of the domain, try to interact with other people because then you'll come to know, you know, what are new updations are happening in the industry. And other main thing is, so if you guys have any queries, please come back to me. Please come to the queries. I know it'll be easy for me to explain it. So I hope I'm able to, you know, pretty much clear about the basic things about your job search for freshers as well as experienced. So based on that, if you have any queries, do let me know. Okay. So now other thing is that now a lot of people come across, when especially females, like, you know, they have a gap in their resume at times due to family pressure or due to, you know, any of the XYZ reason, they have to, you know, leave their permanent job and take a break of 6 months or a year or 5 years or so. So how to come back, you know, with a job or any such thing? So it's very difficult for, you know, whenever there is a gap in your resume, be it a guy or be it a male or a female, for both, whenever there is a, you know, a gap, it's difficult, you know. Okay, now the main important thing is, I have a question that, you know, what does a recruiter see in a resume of someone who had taken a break? That's what I'm talking about. Whenever there is a gap, there has to be a valid reason, because so we come across a lot of people, you know, just because they have any of, you know, the issues and all, like, you know, so there has, it's not like, you know, the main thing is within those period of gap, say, for example, if you have taken a gap of 6 months to a year. So during that period, the main important thing is you need to keep on updating yourself with the technology. The companies are okay with, you know, if you have a valid reason for a break, like if, you know, you had to go for maternity things or any of the things. But when you're going for the interview, first of all, the thing is, a resume has to be so convincing that, you know, and you need to be very clear that, you know, what was the reason behind taking a break. Whenever you are, you know, mailing your resume to anyone, in a cover letter, mention in a small note, you know, that what was the reason behind, you know, taking a break or something. Because no one takes a break because of haywire reason. It always happens to be because of, you know, some other personal reason, or either you know, like, say, for example, especially for females, due to maternity things, due to maternity reasons, they take a break. So in that case, you will be able to explain that, you know, what was the reason behind taking a break and why you were not able to, you know, continue that. There is family commitment and all those, anything can be happen. So when you are going for the interview, make sure that you are updated, you are aware about the organization for which you are going for the interview. So before going for the interview, do a research on the organization. Like if you are going for an ABC organization, go to the website. No, bajega. Mera call hai. I'm so sorry, guys. There was something. Okay, now, whenever you're going for any of the organization, like ABC organization, it is like, you know, you need to, you know, go first, check the company profile, you know, where you're going for the interview, which organization, what is this organization is into. Is your profile, you know, profile is a fit for this? Do you know, if you know anyone with an organization, talk to those people, you know, what exactly, you know, are their, you know, selection parameters and all. And it's always good when you know someone personally within the organization, because you can come to know inside things also. And whenever you have a break, the main questions which they come up is like, you know, what was the reason behind a break? That you need to explain it pretty well. Other question is, you know, what if those circumstances again reoccur. Like say, for example, if you have taken a break due to maternity, so what if you are planning in the future? So how you will handle the situation? Will you again take a break and all? So these are very sensitive questions. So during those interview session, you need to be very, very patient. You need to have a patience. You need to keep your attitude calm. You need to keep your attitude right, because if in case you show your attitude, has happened and all things, or you talk to anything, nothing is going to work it out. So the main thing is, whenever there will be any person who's interviewing you, they look out for your attitude. So you need to keep the right attitude. You should be able to answer whatever they are asking you, like, how will you manage, if in case the certain situation comes occur. Like, apart from maternity, a lot of people gave reasons, like, because of someone's death in a family, they had some property issues which they need to resolve, which is a very common, answers which we get. Now, even if, these are small things which, which you can handle, but how, if you are not able to handle it that time, how will you handle it now? And then if... another thing is, whenever you're going for the interview after a break, you need to be flexible with that, in terms of the salary and all. Like if you're going after, for a job after, say, a year before your salary was, say, for example, it was 6. If now you want your salary has to be 9, or you get a hike of 20% to 30% of hike, you need to give, think about it. At least to start with something, you need to, at least go with the same CTC, because most of the organization don't hire on a negative salary until this is very, urgent. So I'm not asking you to, go for a below the CTC, but at least see to it that you are not asking for a 20, 30, 40% of hike, because for you, the most important thing as of now is to get a job in the organization again. And it might possible most of the organization asked you to sign a bond or something, because whenever you guys are coming for the interview, it's a two-way conversation. Like, me being a recruiter, I might not be able to, take it the things whatever you are saying. You might be lying, that you took a break for so and so reason, or you started a you were abroad and you came back, and now whatever the reason, why should I trust you? So at times, just to just to understand the person is genuine, is serious about the job, those most few of the organization ask them to sign a bond. Bond is nothing but just a kind of and a commitment you are giving to the organization that you will work with the organization at least for minimum 6 months to a year. That is a commitment, and most of the organization, that 1 year, where the 1 year goes, you will never come to know, because once you start the job. And other thing is, you need to be flexible with the timings. Being a female, it's very difficult to be flexible with the timings. If the organization is flexible with the job timings, like say for example, if they're nowadays, if you see, most of the organization is not particular about you have to be there in office. There are few of the organization who are very particular, like if you're late by a minute or so, your half day salary will be gone. But if you see, 80 or 90% of organization have break those rules. You can start working from your home, and your time starts. So organizations are also flexible. So they also prefer the person who is coming for the interview. They should be flexible with the salary, with the timings, and they should have a right attitude. If you come, you are not able to gel with your, the management or with your juniors, then it will be very difficult for you as well as with others as well. So you need to have in a family, we gel with each and everyone the same way. You need to gel with each and everyone. Most of the time, especially if we have a break, it might possible that we are reporting to someone who is junior to us. So a lot of people have that attitude, that he is junior to me, why should I report to him or her? Don't go with that attitude. You are learning something. Even if the person is junior to you, that's okay. Because end of the day, end of the day, what matters is like, you know, how the person is. If the person is very rude to you? No, if the person is flexible enough, then also you have also need to be very cooperative. And these are the things. Then how will you, manage your, okay. Now, one more important thing, especially with, everyone, especially the person is a single, who is a earning member. Okay, how you are managing your expenses during the period when you are not working. You don't have to be very straightforward. You can be diplomatic. That's okay. But these are the basic questions which I'm just giving you an idea. And other thing is, if in case the break is too long, say for example 3 or 4 or 5 years of break, then the question might pop up that, why you want to, work now. I mean, there is a gap of so many years, or you have started a business and now it's not work. So why you want to start again? Why you want to work now again? So whatever is your answer, give your answer with a, right attitude. That is main important. Any more queries on this? Any queries for the break or something? Okay, now to the next point is other thing is that whenever you are, applying for any job, whether be it with a for a fresher or experience with a break or anything. So, okay, now before going ahead, before I forget, I'll show you something. If in case you all are looking out for a job, you guys are there on LinkedIn, if I'm not wrong. Are you aware that LinkedIn helps you to get a job? How many of you are aware that LinkedIn actually helps you to get a job? And you need to update your profile on that. Can anyone answer? Okay, I'll show it to you how you can update your profile on LinkedIn. You can check your LinkedIn profile. And I'll show you on my mobile. Okay, Bhavna, are you aware how to update yourself on LinkedIn if in case you are looking out for a job? Or anyone else? I'm not talking about only the updation of your profile. I'm talking about the settings. So, you can do certain settings on your LinkedIn profile. Are you guys aware about it? Okay, I think you guys are aware. Otherwise, even if you are not, when you go to your profile, you will see, I hope you are able to see, you will see your career interest. Click on the career interest, or if in case you are on a laptop, click on jobs, you will see your career interest. So when you click on career interest, you will see the share of your career interest. You will click on the share interest, or and there is other option is stand out in recruiter searches. So now even if you, so only the people who are working on those particular requirements will come to know. You don't have to worry. Your organization will not come to know that you guys are looking out for a change. I'm sorry. Okay, so now here the first interest. So you need to click on the share your current interest. Okay, and then you have to update it on status, start date and everything. And once you update it, whatever job matching to your profile will, start coming in your email ID. So in that case, those people who, because we keep on postings on LinkedIn or IIM jobs and all with the keywords, and they will ask you keywords. So whatever keywords you are mentioning in your resume, or whatever keywords you have an experience, just mention those keywords on LinkedIn as well. And that's how you are updating, on those recruiters who recruit via LinkedIn that you are looking out for a job. You are actively looking out for a job, or you are just looking for an option. If you get a better option, you have all the three options in that. So that will help you to reach out to more recruiters on LinkedIn as well. And the same way you can do it on IIM Jobs as well. And you can also create your profile on Naukri. You all are aware about it. So if in case you are actively looking out for a job, go to LinkedIn, update your career interest and update your and you know market that you are looking out actively looking out for a job. So it will help you all to get a better job, and it will they will also mail you a relevant requirement which is matching to your profile. Any other queries on that? And now the basic things which you need to take care of it when you are updating your profile or when you're looking out for a job is first of all, everyone knows that you guys will be have to need to update your profile and everything. So I would request you guys to on Naukri or anywhere, keep the basics, but don't share your detailed resume at the first time. The reason behind it, there are a lot of when, especially if you are very experienced, like if you have 13 to 14 years of experience, even if there is a gap, don't you put your basic details and everything in a basic resume and you can upload it. The reason behind it, because a lot of recruiters are there, they without even have talking to you or without having any, they are just flouting your profile. And also, whenever you guys are applying via Naukri or Monster or Time Jobs, most of the time recruiters mention their email IDs or mention their mobile numbers. If they have mentioned their mobile numbers, I request you to please call them once, because while whenever we post any of the job requirement on any of the job portals, we get thousands of profiles. So it might possible that recruiter might miss the your profile. So give if in case you have a number, give them a call, or else you can easily get the numbers on from any of from the net. Give them a call and talk to them and give the idea that you have shared a profile with them. Because in a day, if a recruiter is receiving 200 to 300 profiles, or maybe more than that, it is there are chances that they might miss your profile. So call them once, talk to them. It will build a rapport also. It will build a networking that you're looking out for a job. That they will know you, they will understand you, they know what exactly they are the profile which you have. And then you share your profile with them. And other thing is that if in case you're looking out active looking out for a job, I would request you to update your LinkedIn profile, your Facebook profile, and if in case you have any comments or anything on your previous organization or with your previous or your previous immediate boss or anything, just remove those things, because nowadays before hiring a person, we do a lot of verifications and all in terms of your behavior, in terms of your attitude, in terms of your what you say, your behavioral skills in short. If in case there is something, don't just go and put it on social media. Like say for example, if you have any kind of an argument with the immediate boss, people are like they will not mention the person's name, but they will mention so and so things can happen. Don't do that, because a lot of organization will go and check your FB, Twitter or LinkedIn profiles to see what kind of attitude you have. And also most importantly, update your profile if in case any such things what you're saying about the dates and everything, because we go and look at the if in case you don't have a LinkedIn profile or Facebook profile, I will request you to make it, because a lot of if in case you don't have, it's like the person is not aware about the technology. This is the biggest issue. So go and update it. And also interact with your previous managers, your previous ex previous organizations or your colleague. Build a network with each and everyone. It makes it easy to get a job, to be selected. Because if in case you are aware about or not, say in any XYZ organization, if you're going, your resume is going via them. So if the chances are very high that you are selected, because you are coming from a reference. So the person is already aware of the kind of person you are, the kind of attitude you have, because end of the day, it depends the kind of review the person is giving it to you about you. And always make a good rapport with anyone. And now other thing is that also whenever you're going for the interview, go and look for the company's profile, because whenever you are going for the interview, the first thing is like, you know, for which organization you're going for the interview, what industry they are into, what kind of business they are into, what are and go and check the reviews of any of the organization, because there are a lot of startup organizations as well which are okay with any of the gaps or anything that the best thing is you can go to a Glassdoor. Most of the organization's reviews you will be getting there, whether the good or bad. See how the reviews are there of the organization, whether the salaries are on time or no. Whether, how is the management? Is the management have an open door policy, or is the management is they don't listen to you? So the best thing is whenever you are going, do a breath check about the organization as well. And if in case you are finalized that you have done all the verification, all the details you have taken about the organization and not here, you are like the organization is good and all, then prepare yourself. Talk to if in case you know someone within the organization, with that particular organization, go and talk to the person. What kind of environment they have, what kind of the management they have. So you will come. So before going for the interview, you will come to know, what exactly, how you're preparing yourself. And now here comes one more important thing, which we always face it. I'm so sorry, but there are certain things which you need to be, take care of it when you are going for the interview. Like a lot of people, they don't, almost nowadays, a lot of people are aware, how to be present yourself when you're going for the interview. Like if in case you're going for a media industry and you are in casuals, it's okay. But if in case you're going for the interview for any of the corporate industry, like of a bank or anything, obviously you have to be in a proper formals. And if in case you have a habit of, I'm so sorry, but we have come across certain things and all of wearing, especially for guys, if they have a habit of wearing a bali or something, please remove it. And for females, especially in banks or, a financial institute, they don't prefer any kind of, how do you impress the employer in first 30 days? The first 30 days comes into a picture when you get the job first. So first you need to get the job for that. So it's not about impression. You can impress your employer only with your work. Nothing to do with anything. But yeah, the main important thing is when you're going for the interview for the first time, because your first impression is most of the time is the last impression. So don't be shabby. Be in a proper formals. If being a female, if in case you're not comfortable, wearing Western formals, then please don't wear it. If you're not comfortable with Indian formals, then please don't wear it. Wear it with whatever you are comfortable with. Yeah, there are few of the organizations who ask you to be in, say for example, if I talk about an airlines industry. They want you to be in a proper, they have a proper dress code. That is okay. But if in case you're going for a banking job or any other corporate job or any such things, you are flexible enough, you can go in any job. And especially for BFSI sectors, don't go with those temple tikkas or, with hat mein kuch bhi hai. So because those are something which they don't entertain those things. Even for guys or for girls. Girls still they can, but it's better to be presentable and don't be in any other kind of such things. And also more important thing, see to it the way you are speaking. Gopu, that is pretty fine, but see to it that it should not be shabby or if in case you are taking a dupatta, it has to be a proper, the clothes are properly ironed, because we have come across a lot of females, especially those who are freshers. They don't know how to speak or, you know, how to dress themselves. So there are few of the people we have come across, their hair are very untidy, their dresses are not properly ironed. So if in case you're going for the first time for the interview and don't be with pura pasine mein aap theek hai aapne walk kiya hai, so the first thing is go and freshen up. So wo chote chote cheeze ka dekhna padega. Even if you wear a salwar suit or a sari or a western formal, that is pretty much okay, but see to it that you are looking presentable for on whatever you are wearing. And if in case you're wearing any kind of a jewelry, keep it as simple as minimum, because few of the females have a habit of wearing rings in all the fingers and all. Please don't do that, especially if you're going for a media, depending upon your profile you can go. If you're going for an RJ or anything, it's okay. You are tempted, you have to go for like that only, you have to look like that. But if you're going for a corporate, see to it, these small things. Now, I'll give you one example, which I was also shocked how that was not a female, but it was for a guy. A guy was going for the interview and he had ate a pan. And when I came to know, to be very frank with you, Gopu, jeans would not be okay for men. There has to be proper formal pants. Because jeans comes, on jeans, if you're wearing a t-shirt, it's a casual. On jeans, if you're wearing a shirt, it's a semi-casual. So if you're going for any financial institute for the interview or any big corporates for the interview, or if in case you're going for a senior profile, you have to be in a proper formal pants and a shirt. You can carry a tie along with you if in case you feel that, if you see that in between the environment, the tie is needed or a blazer is needed, you wear it, or else keep it as simple. But jeans is a complete no-no. Unless you have, or else if in case you are going for the interview from somewhere, I would request you to please inform the HR that, because you're not coming directly, you are not available. Say for example, if at times, end moment the interview is scheduled and you're not in a proper formals, inform the, recruiter at least, you're not in a proper formals. Is it okay if you're coming, in a jeans or something? If they say yes, it's okay. If no, then ask for, politely ask for the other timing, other schedule for the interview. So jeans, I'm so sorry for guys being proper formers. Okay. A more important thing for men, if in case you're going for any interview in the financial sector, don't wear a bali or, a earring and kind of a thing. Because a lot of guys have a habit of, due to religious views also, they wear a bali in their ears, and also don't go with that. If in case there is something, then look out for some industry where they are okay with all those things. And whenever you are dressing yourself, see to it for which profile you are going. If in case you are going for a senior management role profile, for a senior manager or above, then it has to be for men's, a proper blazer and all. For females also, yes, video interviews are popular now, but majorly it's for IT or ITES organizations. A lot of manufacturing and other industries are still not going for video interviews. So video interviews are popular. So, and yeah, during video interviews also, you see to it that, you are presentable. It should not be ki haan, chalo, theek hai, video interview hai, toh, aapne kuch bhi pehen liya. Don't do that. Because otherwise, what happen is, what you are presenting yourself, you get a confidence. If you are looking good when you're seeing a mirror, and if you are looking good, obviously you will feel confidence. If in case you are pata nahi main kaisi lag rahi hoon, kaisa lag raha hoon, mera interview kaise hoga, then obviously you're losing out your confidence. Be it a video interview, be it a telephonic interview, or be it a face-to-face round of interview. So your presence, your appearance matters a lot whenever you're giving the interview. Even on telephonic interview, even if you're giving a telephonic interview, see to it, because that gives you a confidence ki how you are. And even if on telephonic interview, if you're not comfortable, you know, the interview while sitting and all, stand up and give the interview. Because whenever we are, standing, we are much more confident than the, you know, we are sitting. Because when we are sitting, we are like, okay, humko koi dekh nahi raha hai, hum log kaise bhi kar sakte hain. And your voice matters. Whenever you're giving the interview over the phone, your voice tone matters a lot. First of all, try to it if it's a face-to-face interview. If it's a telephonic interview, see to it that your tone is proper. Your voice is proper. You are in a proper network area. Any other questions from anyone else? Any new questions about the interview? Okay, now if interview is done, so how to do a follow-up post-interview? Hello guys, post-interview. Okay, now other thing is, let's say for example, your interview is done. So we being a human being, we tend not to take negative feedback. We think about to get a positive feedback always, but that is not the case. In my case, most of the time, 100%, the selection ratio can be less or more. So even if someone is rejecting you, don't feel bad. Take it in a very sporty way. Because if one organization is rejecting you, doesn't mean that, you know, the doors are closed. Prepare yourself in a better way. You need to learn what was the reason. You can ask the recruiter, you know, what is that, if in case they are giving a proper feedback, because most of the time, even we don't get a proper feedback, what is the reason behind rejection? At times there could be your attitude. At times your technical skills are not matching to the profile, because they might look out for someone who is more technically sound than you. And at times it might possible they're not rejecting you, they're keeping you on hold. So have patience. Because, and other thing is, whenever you are in the process of giving the interviews, it might possible that, you know, in the first interview you get selected, or it might possibly you are rejected. Okay, now what is the major factor which makes you not selected post interview? Okay, the major factor would be your technical skills. You are not up to the mark as per the organization requirements. Because a lot of times we come across such people that, they say, we have done this, we have done that, but actually when we interview them, they are not aware about it. Or other thing is, you're not confident. You are fumbling while giving the interview. So whenever you are fumbling, you are not aware what exactly you are speaking about. You are not confident about your own technical skills. And as I said earlier, whenever you're going for the interview, after a break, keep yourself updated, because within 2-3 days, a new updation comes. So what is happening? And at times in person appearance also, they do reject a person. As I was giving one example, there was one female who went for the interview. It was clearly mentioned to her that it is, a counter sales I give it two examples, one for a man and one for this guy. Now there's one guy, he has gone for the interview for a very senior position. Now when he has gone for the interview, he had a long hair, that is okay, but the issue is, for a BFSI sector, long hair for a guy is not allowed. It has to be properly trimmed. And other thing is, as he was wearing a baling. In the same way, there was one more interview. The person was going for a sales profile for a corporate sales. And the person, when he went for the interview, he ate a pan. Now, obviously, for a corporate, they want allow, they won't entertain such kind of a person. Then there was one female who went for the interview. She was, because being a female, we always ask, you know, whether the female is comfortable wearing Western or no. So she was pretty okay. So we had, even if we brief, the person's like, you know, no. So whenever you're going for the interview, so your appearance also does matter. Yes, the vibes of the opposite persons count for the interview. Now, for this, I'll give you a very genuine thing. Like, say, for example, when we are out or, you know, we are, you know, talking to the person or we are chatting to a person for a long time and we are meeting. So sometimes we feel that, you know, no, sometimes we feel that we are connected to a person, but sometimes, you know, we are not connected to a person. So whenever those vibes are there, you know, the person, even if you are good, the person may not reject you, but the person may put you on hold for some other, because the person is not getting a good vibes from your end. Or the person feels that, you know, the kind of attitude you have, the way you are speaking, the interviewer is not getting a good vibes. So it might possible, you know, he might put you on hold instead of rejecting. Or at some of the other cases, if in case the one person feels that the vibes are not coming proper, so he might take a second opinion for the other person, you know, ho sakta hai shayad mere ko aisa ho, you take a second opinion. So the vibes also is important, because end of the day, even the organization is run by a human being. End of the day, the person who is interviewing you, you will be reporting to the particular person. So if the one person is not getting a good vibes from your end, so he will think n number of times, whether I should hire you or no. So most of the time it happens no. Very rare cases, if in case they go for a second opinion, it can be up anything. Now, yes, the candidate can call up the HR person as a follow-up. So, but you need to give it time for at least a day or two, because we also, you know, need time to, you know, follow up with the, you know, hiring people and all those who are taking your interviews. So, and most of the time, if you're going for a senior profiles, for freshers, you come to know each and every, you know, there and there itself. But when you're going for a senior position, they may take a week or so for, you know, to come up to you for a proper follow-up or to give you a proper feedback. So obviously you need to, you know, do a HR follow-up and all, because we deal with so many candidates. So say, for example, if we had been told, you know, the profile has been on hold. So we do a follow-up once or twice. And if you follow up, obviously we'll go and check them again. So you can definitely go and do the follow-up with the HR person. That has to be actually. Any more questions? Hope I'm not missing any question. What is the major factor? Any more question by anyone? Okay, and one more thing, guys, whenever you are, you know, even if you are on a break, see to it that you don't lose out the touch with the area, like be it marketing or anyone, because those are more, Bhavna, what does a person do if he, she has not a good day and the interview schedule for the evening? Bhavni, in that case, it depends upon person to person, like how the life keeps on going. So if you had a bad day, either the one option is, you know, you can call up the HR person, you can try to reschedule the interview, which most of the time it doesn't happen for the senior profiles. Because whenever you are going for the senior profile, Bhavna, you are very experienced, very mature. So you know how to handle your emotions or anything. If there is certain emergencies or something, you can give a reason, like, you know, for any of the emergency things, you know, no one is going to ask you what emergency had occurred or anything. So if there is a very bad day, okay, you can reschedule your interview. That's pretty much okay. But if in case you are able to make it, you know, you are able to control your emotions, give the interview, And I would suggest if you're going for them before, say for example, if you had a bad day and your interview is in the evening, just try to freshen up yourself. Go out, have a coffee, and seek, you know, what is more important to you at this point in time. What the bad day which you had or the job? Because when you are clear what exactly you want, because bad day, we being a human being, we can have a bad day anytime. So we cannot just, you know, keep on rescheduling the interview. Yes, it does happen, the negotiation, depending upon person to person and depending upon the organization to organization. But being a candidate, you need to be very much, like you just can't ask anything. Like you just can't ask 40-50% of hike. Yeah. Because no, on a middle level or a senior profile, company have, 20-30% of hike. 30, they can do it 35. But 40, depending upon the organization to organization. But if you ask 40% of hike or 50% or not 50% or 100% of hike, that is something which is not possible. So see to it, what are you worth for? If in case if the current organization is your CTC has not increased, what is the reason behind not increasing? Because the person look out for each and everything. If you are really, really, really very good and the person is they are open for the negotiation, but not up to, out of their budget. So salary negotiation is possible, but see to it. So you need to find out how much is the company's budget for the particular designation. Because for each and every designation, they have a salary slabs. So you need to negotiate in between that salary slabs. A little bit here and there, it's still okay. Any more questions? So I think we are done with all the question and answers. So before hanging up, I would request you all to, if in case you're looking out for a job or anything, update your social networking sites like LinkedIn or Facebook. Either don't put anything, or if in case you're putting, just keep it updated. Because nowadays we do a lot of ref check and everything, and I personally prefer hiring via LinkedIn on a social networking site, rather than sitting in front of a naukri, because I'm on a niche profile hiring. So I prefer, hiring on social media platforms. So if in case you guys are, so please go ahead and update your profile. And if in case you're looking out for, actively you're looking out for a change job, then update your profile on LinkedIn the way I told you. If in case you need any help, you can contact me. That's okay. Anything else? Hope I'm not missing anything. So, thank you guys. Now, thank you.